Hello friends, this is Tanvi and today we will learn about the far shading losses in solar PV system and the ways of mitigation from such losses. So, let's begin. When a solar PV array has an elevated horizon, say from a nearby mountain range or a newly built high skyscrapers or even city skylines, which reduces the sunlight being received by the PV array. In such cases, shading from the horizon is applied to the entire PV system. During the hours when the sun is below the horizon line, the entire array loses its direct irradiance. And at that time, the energy generated only based on the diffuse solar irradiance. So, in such events, when a solar PV array starts losing solar irradiance because of mega objects in a range of 5 to 15 kilometers distance approx, such losses in PV system is known as far shading loss. Now, let's discuss how we can identify and quantify such losses from PV systems. To model and predict this loss in PV system simulation, the designer must have access to the horizon profile of that location. Horizon profiles can be generated by tools like the Solmetric SunEye or Solar Pathfinder. Solmetric SunEye is a digital handheld instrument that can be easily carried and used at any project site to capture far shading profile. Whereas Solar Pathfinder is a very sophisticated tool, which comes as a package of hardware and software. After capturing the shading profile from project site with Solar Pathfinder, you can easily import the shading profile in your system for further analysis. So, both the SunEye and Solar Pathfinder are equally efficient and accurate when it comes to far shading analysis. Also, with softwares like Meteonorm and Aurora Solar, they can create the horizon profile remotely based on the online contour mapping facility. In fact, any horizon file which lists the azimuth and elevation angles can be used to model a horizon profile. Horizon file usually comes with .hor format. Like in this image, you may see that with a horizon profile, the line is interpolated linearly across each of the points. And the line at the bottom represents the horizon line, which occurred because of far shading. This example is a site in Geneva, Switzerland. So, mostly during early morning and evening times throughout the year, the far shading affects the solar energy generation. Now, how you should mitigate far shading losses from your PV system? Well, while such shadows could be predicted to a fair accuracy, a designer could hardly do anything to mitigate this. She has only two options in such cases. First, she has to get the horizon profile and analyzes the amount of far shading loss happening annually. Then, if the losses is very low, like less than 1%, then she should go ahead with the selected site. And if the loss is more than 1%, she should discard the proposed site or raise alarm to the management about such losses. Discuss with your team and assess the losses and compare with the proposed project site's other value additions, like cost effectiveness, accessibility to local electricity grid and other viabilities. Because at the end of the day, this will impact the solar PV asset, techno-commercially and in long term. So, mitigating or optimizing far shading loss is primarily at the hand of the designer and, above all, the team's decision. Thanks for watching. Please let us know how did you find this video helpful in the comment section. We read all of your comments. And please like and share the video as much as you can. And do subscribe to our channel Minutes to Energy for more interesting videos on solar PV system. Thanks again. See you in the next video.